I think that musicians in general, or anybody who has a platform, should speak out on what they think is right.
From Washington, D.C., this is Latin Culture.
Descalzo, sí o sí. No puedo meter el tenis en el. No puedo meter el pie en el tenis. Porque está hinchado.
Rapping started as a hobby for a teenage Puerto Rican known as PJ. He dreamed of becoming a doctor, and he did. But why not do both? Thus, PJ Sinzuela was born.
I talk a lot about everything. I talk about sex and smoking and drinking and dancing, but I also have songs that are political, and I have songs that are just about a conversation with my mom. I was a fan of like Outkast and Eminem and a couple of rappers from the States. And we started having like these songs, but it was just a hobby. I didn't think I was that good. I just liked writing, so I started writing for people. But I also loved science and wanted to be a doctor. So I finished that, and I said I was gonna take a year off, but I've taken 4 years, and I'm here.
In 2019, 4 years after graduating from med school, PJ embarked on his first official tour. Making a quick stop here, in the US Capitol.
Mano, Sinzuela es porque quiero dejar una huella. Sinzuela es because I want to leave a footprint for future generations. But in Spanish, you can say footprint also as a pathway for other people to take. And that's why Sinzuela.
Esto es por mí, por ti, por nuestro orgullo.
His trail doesn't go unnoticed. PJ was part of a group of artists who got together in Puerto Rico to protest on what came to be known as Ricky Leaks. The scandal that led to Governor Rosselló's resignation.
Hasta se burlaron de los muertos.
So yeah, he's leaving a mark. Plus, his speed is dope, yo.
Ya no hay pero, ya no hay perdón que valga. Esto hasta que te saquemos o que te salga y pa' los guardias.
I think it's not only in Puerto Rico. I think that musicians in general, or anybody who has a platform, should speak out on what they think is right. And this time, almost everybody joined in, from artists and musicians to also athletes who, through social media or through music, spoke about what's happening in Puerto Rico, and the governor, Rosselló, renunció. The power was in the people. The artists just played a role in getting the masses together, and it definitely helped.
Somos bilingües impuestos por el pasado. No hace más fuerte porque no nos ha matado. Por eso tiro un verso en inglés para que pueda entender mi mensaje hasta el que español nunca pudo aprender. Donald Trump, you don't represent my morals.
Yo, PJ, you went outside right now and ran into Trump. What would you tell him? After all, we are just a few blocks away from the White House.
I would actually like to have a conversation. So I think that's the best solution. We are treated as second-class citizens. You could see it how the president tweets about us, saying that he's the best thing that happened in Puerto Rico. He may have heard it. I never planned talking about politics in my songs. It's just been like very hard years for Puerto Rico in general since Maria. Politics, we closed the university because they were making it more expensive, and they were also firing teachers and people who worked in the universities. And I've seen my friends been personally affected by changes in the government and by lack of care and empathy in Puerto Rico. And that's why I start talking about it.
I heard that you're a published author.
Yeah, I'm a published author too. I wrote a children's book called Smartest Than You Cool. I got a couple of them, but that's the only one published. And I've also published as a doctor in medical papers. So in soundcheck. I'm trying to unite both music and science. I study medicine, but education for me is very important. I've done like cancer classes for university kids, and a lot of them ask me how can they have another passion if they like to like draw or they like to sports, but they also want to study medicine. How can they do it, and if it's possible to unite two passions? And I tell them that it is possible. I see myself being a professor or giving charlas or conferences to students of upper level. That'd be great, and I hope I keep doing it. Follow your passions, and you can do more than one thing at a time. Don't limit yourself.
After the devastation of the Hurricane Maria, we began to raise our voices. Now they know that we are American citizens.
That was Lady Lyon, the first female mayor of Puerto Rico's second largest city, Ponce, PJ's hometown. Check her out in a Random 4 series.